Now, let's talk about the Rankine cycle. Now, Rankine cycle and Carnot cycle are not very different, but the difference lies between the point 1 dash and the point over here. If you remember the Carnot cycle, okay, your point 1 and point 4, both were at saturated conditions. So, 1 was saturated vapor and 4 was saturated liquid, okay. But it was a hypothetical cycle. If you want to bring it into actual operation, you will face problem in terms of pumping the feed water, you know, in the pump, because in Carnot cycle your point 3 was somewhere here. Let me put 3C, C for Carnot. So you still have your condensate, which is a mixture of, you know, vapor and liquid. And a pump can only handle liquid. It cannot handle a mixture of vapor and liquid. So you are actually pumping from 3C to, let us say, 4C. So this is not practical. Okay. Now this 1 to 2 is a practical scenario. Okay. Again, it's not very practical because the steam which comes out of turbine, you cannot control perfectly saturated steam. It will go into the superheated region. So this 1 dash is the superheated state of the steam which is coming out of the turbine. Okay. Now 1 dash is the actual condition of the steam which comes out of the turbine, which is shown by the Rankine cycle and not by the Carnot cycle. Okay. Now, when you expand the superheated state steam into the turbine via isentropic expansion, you get a state 2 dash, which is somewhat near to the saturated vapor line. Okay. Now from 2 dash, what Rankine cycle does is that it, you know, converts this vapor liquid mixture entirely into liquid. So this liquid can now be pumped easily via the feed water pump, and the end state is 4, which is not exactly saturated, but it is subcooled. So it is subcooled. So this is a practical scenario which is taken care of by the Rankine cycle and not by the Carnot cycle. Okay, if I bring this onto the TS plot, Carnot cycle is 1-2, but Rankine cycle, as I told you, the turbine coming out of the boiler is superheated. So this is the T superheated. So from this superheated temperature, it comes down to 2 dash, that is the isentropic expansion, and then from 2 dash it is completely converted into liquid in the condenser, that is saturated liquid, Q out, and then you pump it up, okay, to state 4, which is again in the subcooled region. It is again in the subcooled region, and then from here you have your heat addition till 1. Okay, so this is what, this is Q in. Okay, again bringing this onto the Mollier chart. In Mollier chart, you had the Carnot expansion from 1 to 2. But in this, you have from 1 dash to 2 dash. Okay, and from 2 dash to 3, that is the heat rejection. So now you can very well see that you are converting the condensate into exactly saturated liquid, and then you pump it up to 4, and then you add heat into it. Okay. So this is what it does. Now let's look at some mathematical values. Let's start from point 3, that is the pump work. Okay, so 3 to 4 is pump work. Okay, 1 dash to 2 dash is turbine work. This is Q in and this is Q out. Okay. Now let us say you are at, you know, point 3. So enthalpy at state 3 is H3. Okay. So you are at state 3, so H3. You add some energy into it via pump work. You get 2H4. So this is what it is. So if you have to find out WP, it has to be H4 minus H3. Okay. Now you are at H4, you want to go to 1 dash. Okay, so H4 plus you put in some heat and then you reach 1 dash. Okay, and this means that Qin is this. Okay, this is equation 1, equation 2. Now let's go for 1 dash to 2 dash, that is the turbine work output. Okay, and that would be you are at 1 dash, you take out some work output from it, and then your energy level drops to H2 dash. So to find out WT, you have to subtract H2 dash from 1 dash. So this is equation 3. So now we have found out WP, we have found out WT, we have found out W or QN. Okay, now let's come to the last part, that is the Q out. So you are at H2 dash, you take out some heat out of it, that is minus Q out, and your enthalpy drops to H3. Okay. So Q out is this. We have the entire value in front of you. WP, Q in, WT, and Q out. Okay. So if you have to find out the efficiency of the Rankine cycle, then net work output upon heat input. Okay, net work output, we know it is WT minus WP, WT minus WP upon Qin. So just put in these values and you will get your answer for the efficiency of the Rankine cycle. Okay, so this is what the Rankine cycle is, which is almost similar to Carnot cycle, except you know it is taking care of the practicalities of running a vapor power cycle. So this finishes this video on Rankine cycle. Now in the next video, we'll talk about the reheat cycle.